Prediction. I'm going on this way, I guess.
This is what the board wants. Every worker in Halcyon stuffed into one of those chambers. Take him down!
Captain's here. Let's go. I want to see all of you fucking out.
Before the storm and all that.
All right, boss. I'm ready. Let's do this.
YOLO, as the kids say.
After all you've done, all the work you've destroyed, all the money you've cost me, your misguided crusade has doomed Halcyon. Idiot. I'm not the one marching to my death in a maximum security prison. In any other circumstance, I'd admire your boldness. In this one, however, I have only two words for you.
fuck off.
Psychopathic outlaws don't deserve the time. Thankfully, you're in a prison already. Find the nearest cell and get I'm done here. Then I'll drag you to the executioner myself. Is that sarcasm? Do you know what I do to people who employ the lowest, most base form of humor? I fire them. Alas, as you are woefully unemployed, I have to do the next best thing and have you killed. In the next room is the finest auto-mechanical purveyor of death ever made. Try not to scratch the paint with your skull. It was fucking expensive.
It's gonna get low down. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Oh, dang. Oh, no. These don't do much damage to these. Oh, good job. Security, you got a big robot.
Get me out of here.
You don't know how glad I am to see you. You lunatic. You broke into the board's own fortress and killed the chairman just to rescue one doddering old man. You are absolutely out of your mind, and I can't begin to thank you enough. I know, my friend, I know. And now it's finally over. The board's finished. It's only a matter of time before the entire system slips from their grasp. You've broken the board's stranglehold on this colony, and you saved my life. There's still so much we have yet to accomplish. You and I are going to have to work harder than ever to save Halcyon. I'm afraid the situation is far worse than any of us ever anticipated. Earth has gone dark. We haven't received a single message in 3 years. There's been no communication, no signals, nothing. 2 years ago, the Earth Directorate's frigate disappeared on their way back to Earth. We don't know what they discovered when they arrived, or if they arrived at all.
Hold on, Doc. Are you telling me the Earth went dark 3 years ago, and the board's just been covering this up?
They've been incredibly effective at concealing the truth. Right now, the only people in the colony who know are standing in this room.
So we've got to make do on our own. Seems to me that'll make us stronger in the end anyhow.
You're quite right. We've got no choice but to make do on our own. We're in serious trouble, my friend. Do you know what this means for Halcyon? We can't rely on Earth for support anymore. We've been cut loose. We're entirely on our own. Yes, you're right. The road is long, and we haven't a moment to waste. We must begin the revival process immediately, starting with the Hope's brightest minds, and then we're going to fix this damn colony, one problem at a time. We're going to need a leader, and I can't imagine a better person for the job than you. What do you say, old friend? Will you help us? I can't tell you how glad I am to hear that. When I revived you, I thought we were going to save this colony all by ourselves. But I was wrong. We can't save Halcyon on our own. We're all going to have to pull together, somehow. We are not a colony anymore. Our last connection to Earth has been severed. I don't know if we'll survive, but we're going to have to try our best.
At the end.
The OSI teaches that everything in the universe happens according to the grand plan. But the stranger that arrived in Halcyon was an unplanned variable. From the moment he landed in Emerald Vale, his actions altered the course of history. The events on Tartarus brought about the end of the Board's authority. But the Board's mistakes would haunt the colony for decades to come. The damage they left behind would require the work of a generation to repair. Dr. Phineas Wells began reviving a handful of the Hope's colonists. Engineers, scientists, technicians, and intellectuals. They were among the brightest minds the Earth had ever sent out into the stars. The Hope scientists and engineers woke up in a colony descending headlong into total collapse. With no way to return to Earth, they had no choice but to band together and devote themselves to the cause of saving Halcyon. The people of Halcyon were nothing if not hardy. In the absence of the Board's authority, many of the colony's settlements banded together with a single purpose in mind, survival. Life was especially hard in the years to come. Some towns dissolved by attrition and starvation, but most of them found a way to carry on. In the years to come, Halcyon was forced to reckon with its newfound freedom. The Board was gone, and for better or worse, the colony was responsible for its own destiny. As the colony struggled to survive, the inspirational story of the Iconoclasts spread like wildfire. Zora's focus on logistics made for a safer monarch, where the Iconoclasts enjoyed a surge of new blood looking to join the ranks from struggling townships. Life on Monarch slowly improved from a desperate fight for survival to prosperous growth and more permanent strength. The collapse of Edgewater left its workers bereft of any purpose in life. Most of them made their way to Adelaide McDevitt's camp, hoping to ingratiate themselves into her favor. Adelaide accepted only a few to her community. The rest were turned away and likely died of starvation. Nevertheless, Adelaide's camp grew into a well-established town. Adelaide McDevitt refused to cooperate with the ongoing effort to save Halcyon from collapse. A sympathetic deserter stole a copy of her research and delivered it to the Hope's scientists. It is unclear how useful Adelaide's research was. An optimistic estimate suggests her work may have bought Halcyon another few years of survival. Adelaide would never know. She died that winter. Under the leadership of Junlei Tennyson, the Groundbreaker held firm against corporate influence. The ship's mechanical stability gave Junlei the time to educate a promising generation of engineers schooled in her family's traditions. The future of the Groundbreaker looks promising. The rediscovery of the Hope and the abandonment of the lifetime employment program forced Byzantium to come to terms with some uncomfortable realities about the state of Halcyon. While Byzantines were reluctant to surrender the luxuries they'd grown accustomed to, the Board's diminished authority gave them little choice in the matter. Nearly everyone had to learn to make do with less. Some even had to get jobs. It was a dark time indeed. Life in Halcyon was sobering for Felix Maelstrom. The grand revolution he dreamed of never came. There was no great awakening for the colony, no celebrations in the streets. There was only the hard, desperate work of trying to repair a broken colony. Felix never had a head for numbers, but if there was labor to be done, he was there to help. Eventually, Felix realized that the work of a revolution was done with two hands. Once the matter with the Hope colonists was resolved, Junlei bashfully asked Parvati if she'd like to join her permanently on the Groundbreaker. And Parvati, enthusiastically if somewhat awkwardly, agreed. The stories of her adventures spread across the colony, and Parvati soon found herself the center of attention. Having served as the engineer of a renowned spacecraft, tramp freighters and wildcat miners sought her out by name. And in no time, she was a fixture in the Groundbreaker's mechanical ecosystem. She and Junlei were never far apart. Nyoka didn't survive her adventure with you. The SAM unit that accompanied you spread awareness of the product line's superior sanitation and maintenance capabilities across what was left of the colony. This led to a...
Wait, how did she not survive? No one died.
Did you know that SAM units are the longest-lasting, toughest-acting cleaning solution in Halcyon? Minister Clark was released from house arrest, and his contact with you gave him a sense of renewed purpose and vigor. Once it became clear that no help would be coming from Earth, he threw his considerable efforts and talents into helping Halcyon manage the crisis before it. As for Dr. Phineas Wells, he spent his remaining years in his orbital lab. Though he was always haunted by the failures of his past, he was determined to make things right by building toward the future. Dr. Wells was able to revive many more scientists and engineers than he first expected, thanks to the additional batch of chemicals you stole from the Ministry. Wells never forgot about the human lives that were lost in acquiring these chemicals. The revival project was hard and painful work, but in the end, despite limited resources, over half the Hope's colonists were successfully revived. Even after Wells passed away, the Hope scientists and engineers worked night and day to pull Halcyon from the brink of collapse. Their efforts continue to this day, which may be reason enough for optimism. Dr. Wells laid the groundwork for the project to save the colony, but he would never live to see the fruits of his labor. He passed away a few years later. His work was carried on by the scientists and engineers he revived. Life will never be the same in Halcyon. It is widely agreed that the colony has a chance of stabilizing within a generation, owing to the hard work and determination of the surviving colonists. Recovery is a distant goal, and the path is long and uncertain. But the people of Halcyon carry on, determined as ever. And what about you, the unplanned variable in the history of Halcyon? Long after Wells passed away, you carried on his work with more energy, determination, and brilliance than he could ever muster. The years that followed were hard, but Halcyon survived by the efforts of the Hope's most promising colonists, the greatest of which was you. No one knows what's happened to Earth, and no one knows what the future has in store for Halcyon. All we know for certain is this. The name of the Unreliable and that of its intrepid captain will remain the subject of countless stories for years to come.
So, yeah. That was... Alright. I guess... I don't know if I can go back and do more stuff. But I don't think I'll go back and do stuff on the video. So, the game was... Alright, fuck. Pretty short though. I feel like it could have even lasted through the game faster, which is right. I'm pretty sure I missed lots of. I don't even think I went to like a few locations on the map. It was really weird the way I played it. I'm gonna do a second playthrough, and I'll do it on my own. And probably do it more slow, like, some other what, 3 days? Other than that, I'll only be able to play it part of the weekends, but I'll do Supernova or bike with it. Loadout of not running and gunning, but Swiper, the chat dialogue skills and sneaking skills, and go for more of the the board line or whatever. So exciting with them and the operations or whatever. See how that goes. I missed like two of the things, and I barely got the Sam thing. Game also feels just like kind of small to me, but I think just because going from planet to planet just feels like I said, small. It's not like one giant area like other Fallout games, so. When you go to a planet, it doesn't feel like the size of a planet, it's like the size of like a city. A few small city and small area, so. I'll probably get this up. This like maybe like an 8 out of 10 from what I played right here. I don't feel like I went very in depth with it, but it's probably another reason. Yep, can't think of any other thoughts in there. I don't know, I just don't feel like I explored it enough, but I'll explore more in the harder mode and hopefully be able to do like all the quests, unless there's like a bunch of quests, but for my, it doesn't look like there's too many quests with how small the area are, and obviously I can only do certain types of them if I go down a certain route, so. I feel like I should have maybe waited. I spent $60 on this ending. It's definitely worth it more than other games for $60, but it still doesn't feel like I'd want to pay $60 for just waited here or something. Is there any more after this? Can I skip it? No. I'm guessing they're gonna set up a PS sequel where you have, like, it's in the future and you have to try and find out what's going on with Earth and how successful the game. It's my assumption. Unless they just did this as a some IP and then maybe do something else for the next project. I haven't really kept up with what Obsidian has said about it. hours of credits is there going to be? Oh, I just hit escape and that was it. Alright, oh, well, that's the end. First one I've actually completed because it's not as long as the other ones. Grinding I needed to do, really. So it's on. Or whatever. The next one would probably be longer just for all the probably difficulty of it. Alright, the end.